if I take a high skew inverter, we said the size is going to be 2.5, right? Now, some of you had a question, what if half is not allowed, right? What if half is not allowed in the technology? The point is, logical effort is independent of that gate size scaling. So what I'll do is, now I'll show you that if whether I take 2.5, right, or whether I take 1.4, you will get the same answer. Okay, so now this is my high skew inverter. Let's say I want to now calculate the pull up logical effort, and this is my pull down logical effort. So I'm going to construct my reference inverters. So what do I do? If I'm looking at pull up, then I ensure that PMOS transistor size remains the same, right? So this 4 will just appear here. And if that is 4 and I want the inverter to be a symmetric static CMOS inverter, the NMOS should be 2. So this will give rise to the 2 here, right? And therefore, what is the logical effort now? G pull up. It is 5C divided by what? 6C, right? So you get 5/6. Now what about pull down? This is my reference inverter. What I'm going to do is, this 1 will appear here. Now if this is 1, what should be the PMOS? 2. And therefore I get logical effort pull down equals how much? 5/3. This is what we got yesterday, right? 5/6 and 5/3. Clearly the pull down is greater than 1, pull up has been made less than 1. So it doesn't matter whether I take 2.5, 1.4, 2.8, all of that is the same. Okay, clear? Any questions on the high skew inverters or high skew, low skew inverters? Okay. So today we will look at some special functions. Okay. What I'm going to do is, first let me just quickly review the static CMOS implementation once. Okay, let me take NAND 2 again. A and B. What is the function that is being implemented in the pull down network? Y equals AB bar, because it's being pulled down to the 0. Therefore, I have to invert it, right? This is pull down. What is the pull up? A bar plus B bar. Clearly, YPD equals Y pull up. Right? This has to be consistent. Okay. In general, if I have a pull down network and a pull up network, then I can say that my Y pull down is sum F bar of A, B, you know, or let me say A1, A2, AN. F bar, because it is going to ground, I have to invert that function. And I am saying A1, A2, AN because these are active high switches. The switches turn on when the input goes high. The general notation is this. Similarly, if I want to write the pull up network, it is some other function G of what? A1 bar, A2 bar and AN bar. What's the condition? These two have to be the same. YPD is equal to YPU. Both stacks have to implement the same function. That's quite obvious, right? Now the question is, under what circumstances will both these stacks be a mirror image of each other? I want my PMOS stack to be a mirror image of the NMOS stack, which means that whatever input A1 is, you know, connected to an NMOS transistor, it is connected to a similar PMOS transistor on top, right? So, if the PMOS stack was a mirror image of my NMOS stack, okay? If PMOS stack, right, or the pull-up network, let me say in general, was a mirror image, and mirror image because I am taking the mirror image about that x axis. It's going to ground, I'm making it go to VDD. That's all. That's why I'm saying mirror image. Otherwise, it's effectively the same stack, right? Mirror image of the pull down network. Then, what is the pull up function that is being implemented? YPU is if the pull down network, okay, given YPD, right, given is F bar of A1, A2, AN. Now, dual of it, but in terms of F and the A1, A1 bars, what is it? F of, exactly, this is nothing but F of A1 bar, A2 bar, AN bar. Now, we know our other constraint that the pull down function and pull up function have to be the same. Therefore, F of A1 bar, A2 bar, AN bar should be equal to F bar of A1, A2, AN. What does this mean? It means that if I complement my inputs, A1 becomes A1 bar, A2 becomes A2 bar and so on, then the output also becomes a complement. What I am doing here is inputs are getting complemented. What this is doing is output is getting complemented. So, if by complementing the inputs, the output also gets complemented, then I can make my PMOS stack a mirror image of my NMOS stack. And that is what was given to you in the assignment, where we said implement Y equal to AB plus BC plus CA whole bar. Right? So, what is the advantage of this? So,
you take y equal to ab plus bc plus ca whole bar, and we do an, let's first do a vanilla static CMOS implementation of this, right? Then, you know, I will simplify this further. I will just say AB plus C into A plus B. So this will be C. A, B, and I have another A and B here.
Right? Now, what is the PMOS stack? If I were to do it in the original way, where the PMOS stack is just a dual of this NMOS stack. So A and B have to be in parallel. There is a series there. So I am going to put A, B. Then I have C in series with A and B, which means I am going to put C in parallel now with A and B in series. Right? So C A B. Okay. So can you size these transistors now? So what should this PMOS sizing be? What's the worst stack size? How many transistors on the stack? 3. So therefore I need 666, right? So therefore this has to be 6 6 6 and 6, right? And therefore this has to be 3. Clear? Now let's check if this condition is satisfied where I can use the mirroring property. Okay, so what is the mirroring property? It simply says that if I complement the inputs, output should also become a complement. Okay, so you can work out this Boolean logic yourself by, you know, putting A bar, B bar, C bar, you worked it out, you will get the same function. Okay, but I'll show you the simpler way, which is the truth table way. A, B, C, output Y.
0 1 0 0 1 1.
So what is this? AB plus BC plus CA, right? If any two are 1, then you get output as 1. 0 0 1 0 1 1 1. Clear? So this is what my output Y is, min term of this is AB plus BC plus CA. Of course, if you want the complement, then it's just the reverse, right? So this is min terms of, you take zeros, 1 0 1 2 4, 0 1 2 4. What is Y bar? Min term of summation. Summation of 3, what? 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. Okay, this is Y and Y bar. Question now is, if I invert the inputs, will the output get inverted? So you look at 0, 0, 0. If you invert 0, 0, 0, what do you get? 7. So you will see that this 0 becomes 7. What about 1? 0, 0, 1. Huh? What do you get if you invert the inputs? 0, 0, 1 becomes, that is 6.
Exactly. So, this
2. 0, 1, 0 becomes 1, 0, 1, which is 5. And of course, 0, 1, 1, if you invert, you will get 1, 0, 0, which is 4. So, clearly, by inverting the inputs, the output is getting inverted. And therefore, I can apply the mirroring property here. Clear? So, if I apply the mirroring property, the advantage is I can just replicate the NMOS stack. Now, the advantage is the NMOS stack has only 2 transistors on the stack. Correct? So, with mirror implementation, it would simply this whole thing would become what? Just a mirror image of this. See? A, B. And this is A, B again. So, what's the gate size now for this? 4? This is 4? 4 and 4. Clearly, the logical effort on each input has come down now. Right? This is the advantage. Now, it's not necessary that every time you replicate the NMOS stack, it's going to be better. In this one example, it happened to be like that. First of all, there are very few functions where this will hold. Okay, another function where this holds is the 3 input XOR. If I take Y equals A XOR B XOR C, then on this, again, the mirroring property will hold. You can go verify it for yourself. Again, write down the mean terms. See what happens when you invert the inputs and see if the output gets inverted. Right? There are very few functions where this can be done and it can be exploited very well. If that function is important, it turns out this function is very important because this is nothing but the carry out of your full adder. And the 3 input XOR is the sum of your full adder. And therefore, these two are very important functions in the ALU. And we are able to exploit this mirroring property beautifully in order to reduce the logical effort on these inputs. Any questions here? So, the key point, yeah. I will come to that later. Yeah. Okay. So, the key thing is, if your PMOS stack is large and your PMOS size therefore is going to be very large, your logical effort is going to be very high. You have no choice. Right? Basically, the PMOS stack summary is, maybe I'll just write it here. Summary is, PMOS can kill your logical effort. And lot of effort will now be put in order to optimize this PMOS stack. One such technique is this mirroring property. Okay.